Our brave hunters venture into a school that is supposedly haunted, Jackson Independence School. Here, the students and staff frequently report mysterious and frightening things. Things that can never be explained. Things that appear to be nothing to the naked eye, but when caught on camera, do you see something? We're here to figure that out.
Your side of the story?
It's been probably been about 15 years ago. That was back when Boyd Riley worked with me. We was actually locking up one night and we were standing about where the front entrance was on the inside of the building about 10 o'clock one night. And we was getting just ready to go down and lock the end doors and leave. Not once we hear, we hear the back door open. We hear steps go up the back stairs. Boyd looks at me and he said, "Somebody just went up the back stairs." I said, "Well, you go up the back stairs, I'll go up the front stairs, we'll meet at the top and we'll find who it is." Well, that's to believe. And we'll lock the building up. So he goes up the back stairs, I go up the front stairs, we meet in the hallway, nothing. He says, "Nobody here." I said, "Okay, we check the bathrooms, we check all the classrooms." Back down the hallway, nothing. He said, "Now over there." I said, "Let's go downstairs, lock the front door, and go home as quickly as we can." That's the true story.
Could they have possibly went down the elevator as you were coming up from the stairs?
Was no elevator back at that time. We had a breezeway that went from this building up to the other building, mm-hmm. And all we could get upstairs was walk upstairs.
Interesting. Okay, so I heard a story about a balloon story. Can you elaborate on that for us?
Yes. It was on Thursday about 8 o'clock at night, August 20th, 2009 is when it happened. It was on my birthday. And they told all the birthdays that day. They didn't mention mine. That was my first year here. And it was 8 o'clock and Charlie left. And then boys that was practicing ball, they left. So I was in the gym cleaning, and I come back through this area here by that second water fountain. I come up to my closet, and I heard something. I said, "Man, somebody's come back in the building," but I'd never really seen nobody. I looked down that way, and I seen a balloon above that second water fountain. It was kind of freaky, you know, because it said happy birthday on it. So I went back down that way, and I looked at it, and I kind of laughed. I said, "I wonder who's playing my jerk in my chain tonight." So I went on down there to the gym, and I cleaned a little bit more. When I come back through, the balloon was gone. So I looked everywhere for that balloon. I said, "Man, someone brought that in here and played a game with me." Well, yeah, I never did find it. And so I got kind of nervous, and I actually used my phone. I called somebody and asked them about this place. Because this was my first year working here, and they said, "Someone got killed up here." And I said, "Man, that's freaky." So I started freaking out after that. So I went and got my car for my last 30 minutes, and then I left. But the next day, Charles White came in because he had to work for Clyde, and he found that balloon down the stairs here in his girl's bathroom.
Who thinks he had an encounter with a ghost?
No, dude, seriously, it was real. Like the other day, I was getting in my truck. I get in my truck, and I started, and my engine's wrong. Okay, so, and then all of a sudden, this green smoke was like coming out and stuff. And this ghost came out of like the floor air conditioner and like was like moving around and stuff. You couldn't, like, he wasn't like a person. He was just like smoke. And he was like, ooh, and he started moving. So my eye, like, running out of the truck. And the ghost gets out of the truck. And it, like, it doesn't close the door. Very rude. And so, like, he keeps going and following me. And I, like, run to my house. I close the door. And, like, the ghost, like, knocks on the door. And then it just, like, he starts going away. And then I went back outside, got back in my truck, and continued to spray paint the logo on my truck. I use a lot of spray paint.
Is that how you got your truck stuck down there earlier today?
No, this was like 6 months ago. I got my truck stuck. Actually, it was a funny story. I thought I heard the ghost coming for me again, and I'm like, sure, and I'm like, oh God, and then, yeah. And so it went in the ditch, but I see, it only seems to show up when I'm painting things.
But why don't you paint something right now?
I don't have paint, and this does not belong to me. Otherwise, I'd paint it.
Okay, well, thank you for letting us know your encounter.
Dude, I don't know if you're the ghost or not, man. I don't want to shake no hands.
Well, you just get out of here.
Was there a door, man?
Yeah. And that is a very credible witness, obviously. Well, I guess we found Charles. So, can you tell us about Maxine?
Yes, I can. She was like 8 years old when she fell down the stairs.
Which stairs?
That was the old building. It burned in 1967, I believe. So this building was built in 1968. The old stairs where she fell would be coming down of the TV station downstairs to the stage. Used to go down into an auditorium out of the cafeteria. So that's where she fell in. But the really spooky part about it is up here at night sometimes, can I turn this light on? I can be down here, I usually try to save electric and mop the lights off, but I can be down here and I'll go down here. Well, I listen and there's a door, like somebody's stuck in it, can't get out. Come down here, I'll show you. This right here would be like going to the old balcony in the old gym. And I hear there was a kid fell over that balcony in 1960. This right here is the ceiling of the old gym.
Oh.
Yeah. And you used to be able to come through here, and there was a balcony that you could look out on towards the court. And they said that there was a little kid about, like, in second grade that fell over and broke his neck.
Awesome.
And sometimes you can let me shut that door once. Come on in.
Come on, guys. Mm-hmm. Nothing to be afraid of.
Yeah.
All right. They're not real.
Like I was saying, sometimes I'll be way down the hall and there won't be anybody up here and I'll be hearing like this door. Like a kid hollering, let me out. I come down here and look in and there's nobody around.
Okay, upstairs.
That's a true story.
Okay, guys, let's get out of here. I'm not sure if I can take much more of this.
And it was refurbished, you know, in 1975. And this is not the talk about the guy that fell off the scaffold during the 1975 construction. So you would have to talk to John about that.
Talk to him, you guys.
This year, we have a little town. They used the window, so they had a coal burn down there. That's how they used to do it. far as I know, the story of the basement, that would go back to Cecil.
He was buried under the concrete.
Look how old this is. That's sure to have some sort of spirit in it. It's like an empty. Okay, now we're in the basement. What now?
Creepy down there, man.
That is a...
So, is this is the scary bathroom?
Yep.
Scary bathroom.
Got this. Ain't nothing in here. Ooh.
We're gonna stay here and wait for Charles.
Where are we going?
And now you go get Charles and we'll wait for you out here. We're gonna watch for the little girl. No, you'll be fine. I'm sure it'll go. Be careful. You're welcome.
The car's gone. Ryan and Dylan left us. I found the camera, but not Tony and Tyler. I can only assume they're alone now.
Okay,
we
got away from that. What was that?
There was something there. Nothing wasn't. There was nothing there. What was there? There was nothing there. There was a ball. Okay, it was a ball. You guys afraid? You were afraid of a ball. I mean, come on. It was just a ball. There's nothing there. Let's go find out what's there now.
There is nothing there.
Stop it. You were afraid of a ball. Just a little soccer ball. Like there's anything there. And a noise that you may or may not have heard. So why am I so afraid? You're not afraid. Okay. What was that? There's nothing there. Yes, there is. There's something there. I swear I hear something.
That's just the voice. That's the intercom. That's that intercom right there. There's nothing there.
Okay. Gotta get a hold of myself. Okay. This water fountain is scary. Okay. I got my drink of water. Okay, I'm coming around the corner. Just to, I don't want to let you out. Okay, let's turn the light. Okay, that's a lot better. Okay, now. Okay. Now, is there anything there? Is there anything there?
Ah! So, do you think that story was actually scary? Oh my god. Oh, that's the little girl's ball, Tyler.
Come play with me.
Where is she?
Come see.
Is she in the girl's bathroom? Why is the door open? Open it, Tyler. Boy. Let us in. There's nobody there. Nobody's in here. There's a wall there. I will hope she's gone by the time we get out of here. She's gone.
Where'd the ball go?
In here? Oh. Tyler, don't! It's possessed! Why isn't she going for it? she in the girls' bathroom again? What was that? I hope she doesn't reach and get it. It's coming back for her.
Die, it went dark.
Well, we just got back to this haunted school.
We met everyone. We got too scared.
Tanya is dead.
Deacon is dead.
Tyler's behind us dead.
He was slaughtered in the teacher's lounge.
All of our crew is dead.
This school is haunted.
Stay away!
Bloopers.
Wait, so...
Yeah, well, I'm out.
Where's Dayton? Where is he?
Where do we go?
Oh my lord, open your bones and share.
Guys, we're done recording. Go ahead.
Okay.
Bye, Dayton.
Okay, cool.
I'm okay with this.
Open the door.
I can't.
Why?
You tell me.
Oh my god.
Guys, turn on the light.
The lights are on.